Welcome to today's contest here from Chelmsford, where the Rocket D Squad will take on the Chelmsford Cougars. It is October 11th. Got a decent day for football, partly cloudy, a little cool, right around 50 degrees. So it should be a good little contest. The Rockets enter this game 0-4, looking for their first win. Everybody appears to be healthy for the Rockets. And we'll see what kind of a game we get. So our captains today, which, let me see if I can get a view. If you want to. Okay, your captains for today's contest are number 6, Giacomo Iapica, and number 33, Carter Leonard. I believe the Rockets are going to be receiving the ball to open up the game. And we'll be back with the kickoff. Okay, the Rockets will be kicking off as number 6, Giacomo Iapica, gets ready to boot the ball away. Chelmsford with standard 2 return men deep. Ready on the right, ready on the left, and book game is underway. Good kick by Iapica. Ball's rolling around. As the Chelmsford, this kid is fast. Wow, he's running. He just took off, taking the opening drive, the opening kickoff, all the way down for a touchdown. As the Cougars come out scoring on the first drive, the opening kickoff. We've got Chelmsford 6, Reading nothing. Okay, Chelmsford comes up to the line of scrimmage for the extra try. They are in a shotgun formation with the tailback split to the right. Quarterback will keep the ball. He's looking for room outside. And he's across the line for 2 points, for an extra try. So Chelmsford will end up being 7, Rockets 6. Okay, the Rockets will get ready to return the ball. Number 3, Braden Nowicki, number 7, Brendan Lindmark. There's a, will look to be like a, like an onsides, but it is recovered by number 41, Sean Crowley. And Rockets will take over first down. Okay, first and 10 for the Rockets. They're about midfield, right around the 49-yard line. Looks like they've got Centrella at quarterback. They're in the I formation. The give is to Mascherelli, who's got a hole. And he has a nice little run there for about 8 yards, second down. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage after a nice run. Back in the I formation. They got a wide receiver left. The give is right up the middle. And it's to, looks like number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis. And he gets enough to move the chain. So first down, Rockets. Rockets come back to the line of scrimmage. Moving the ball pretty quickly here, almost like a no huddle. And the give again is to Mascherelli, who's got some room on the outside, but he's finally tackled, chased down by Chelmsford. And he gets about 3 yards on the gain, so it's second down and about 8 to go. Rockets come to the line of scrimmage, wide receiver right this time. Centrella gives the signal. Pitch pass out to Mascherelli, who's got some room along the outside. And oh, nice hard running by Mascherelli. The offensive line right there really gave him some nice room to run. Number 70, Brady Swanson was out there. Number 71, Colin Donahue was out there. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica was out to help him out. Some good blocking by Aiden Beckenhuis. Well, it was good team effort there to get Mascherelli across for a first down. Rockets are moving the ball well here on this drive. Centrella takes the snap. Mascherelli's got, thought he had a hole there. It looked pretty good, but then Chelmsford did a nice job of just filling the gap and holds Mascherelli for about a 1 yard gain. Second down. Sticking with the I formation. Wide receiver right. And it's going to be a pitch pass again to Mascherelli, who's got some room. And he's driving ahead hard for about 4 yards on the carry. Number 72, Sean Murphy, was in there to really move the line. Along with, let's see, number 50, Jason Anderson. You got third down. About 5 yards to go for the first. Trying to keep the drive alive. This time they're in a, it's like almost like the moose formation. And Mascherelli again takes it for a gain of about a yard. So it's going to be a big fourth and four here as the Rockets will huddle up. Rockets come to the line of scrimmage looking to keep this drive alive. Fourth down, 4 yards to go. Mascherelli's at the quarterback. He's going to keep it himself, and he's got some room. Excellent, excellent blocking by the offensive line to give Mascherelli plenty of room on that. Looked like Donahue, Swanson, and looks like Anderson was also over there to open up that hole and keep this drive alive. So first down for the Rockets. Okay, let's see here. Let's see if the Rockets can punch it in. They're about the 9 yard line. Well executed drive so far. And Mascherelli, nope, it's Beckenhuis this time. And he has stopped for no gain on the play. Rockets will try again. They got Nowicki, wide receiver left. The ball is going to be given to, I believe it was number 8. Nope, that was number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis. Third down. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage back in the power eye formation. Centrella calling the play. The give is to Mascherelli, who's met immediately at the line of scrimmage. Don't know if he was able to move the down marker on that play. It does not appear that way. Maybe about a half a yard on the play. Okay, back to fourth down. Need about 4 yards to get into the end zone. Really big play here. And Mascherelli is the quarterback, and unfortunately, he is wrapped up behind the line of scrimmage. And that is going to be a turnover for Chelmsford as they will now get the ball. So, very good drive by the Rockets. Just came up a little bit short on the try as they will now go on defense. All right, so we'll get a look at the Rocket defense here. As Chelmsford goes with the pitch pass. They've got number 3, Nowicki, in pursuit, 21, Beckenhuis in pursuit, 50, Anderson in pursuit. So they're finally able to bring down the ball carrier for a gain of maybe a yard. Rockets are sticking with their standard 5-3 defense. Mascherelli, Centrella, and Beckenhuis playing your linebackers. Nowicki and Leonard in your corner. They're going to pass the ball. And just a little bit overthrown. Mascherelli was in coverage as well as 33 Leonard, so third down. Even here. Third down, 8 yards to go. Chelmsford. the quarterback is—he's in the shotgun and he's going to be a keeper. And boy, this kid is moving on the outside. He's finally pushed out of bounds by—don't know who was on the play on the corner there. Looked like it might have been. It looks like it might have been Mascherelli or Leonard, so it was one of the two that was able to knock the ball carrier out. And stops from short of the first down. They've got fourth and four. Jordan Whitmer. All right, see if the Rockets can hold him here. And the quarterback is going to keep the ball. He's got some room on the outside. And he's trucking along here, folks. He's running. This is the number one again. He's going to turn this into about a nice run by the Chelmsford ball carrier there. It's about an 80-yard touchdown run, 75-yard touchdown run. Took it on the outside, kept it himself. And the Cougars will go up 13-0. I know. Okay, the Cougars will line up for the extra attempt, or the extra try, rather. And the running back is going to try to bounce outside. He's trying to get in, and he plows through for the extra try. So the attempt is good. So with about a minute left, actually that is the end of the first quarter, with the Cougars 14, Rockets 0. Okay, our first player profile today, we're going to look at number 22, Jordan Whitmer. Jordan is a fifth grader at the Barrows Elementary School. His favorite food is Roni pizza, pepperoni pizza, good choice. His favorite superhero is Batman, and when he's not playing football, he enjoys playing Minecraft and playing other sports. And when he grows up, Jordan Whitmer wants to be an archaeologist. So that's number 22, Jordan Whitmer. So the Cougars will get set here to kick off. Looks like they've got number 7, Lindmark, and number 3, Nowicki, deep. And the old ready on the right, ready on the left. And they're gonna kick it deep this time. Ball is kicked to number 7, Lindmark, who's trying to find a hole. He's trucking ahead. Follows his blockers up for a little bit of a gain. So the Rockets will take over on their own 38-yard line, first and 10. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Looks like a little bit of confusion on the line. And yeah, there's a little bit of confusion. So coaches do a wise thing and they call the timeout. You're ready. All right, the coaches, Swanson and crew, get everybody settled away. And the Rockets will come up to the line of scrimmage on first and 10. The ball carrier is going to be Mascherelli. He's got some room on the outside. Nice little run. Great hole, once again, by the offensive line. And that is about an 11-yard run, so that's enough to move the chains. First down. Ball about midfield, exactly, right on the 50-yard line. There's number 22, Whitmer. Coming out playing wide receiver. And it looks like I don't know who that was running the ball, but he took a pretty good hit. And I can't tell who that was running the ball. Looks like number 8, Mascherelli. He got hit pretty good there running through. Nice hard run by Mascherelli, but they're gonna give him a breather. And we've got second down. The Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Beckenhuis is going to keep it himself. He's got a little bit of room. And he does a nice job of scrambling up ahead to get the first down. So that'll move the chains. Rockets inside of Cougar territory. So first down for the Rockets, as they've got Centrella under center. Looks like they're going with the moose formation. No, that was, excuse me, Beckenhuis was under center. He's nice hard running. Gets a couple yards on the play. Went outside. I think Nowicki was out there blocking for him, so really good job being able to move the ball. About 7 yards to go. Rockets are at the 30, at the Cougar 32-yard line, trying to keep this drive alive. And Beckenhuis is going to be the ball carrier again on the play, and nice move by Beckenhuis to keep his feet chugging ahead as two Chelmsford defenders came in and gave him a good little pop there, but he kept his feet chugging, and it's enough to move the chain. So great play by the Rockets, first down. All right, Rockets trying to move down there and obviously get this ball across the goal line. They've got Muscarelli back in the game. He's got the ball himself, and he's trying hard to get out, get across the, looks like they need to get across the 15-yard line for a first down. He came close, and he's going to be about a yard short, so coming up third down. Rockets come out with a yard to go for the first. And the carrier is Muscarelli again. And he's going to get enough for a first down. So good enough to move the chains for the Rockets. Okay, first down. 10 yards to go for the Rockets. They're at about the 11-yard line. And Muscarelli's going to try to pass it this time. Looked like he wanted to throw deep. It looked like the intended target on the play might have been 81, Zachary Galvin. But the Chelmsford defender was able to come in there and pull Muscarelli to the ground for a loss of one. So we've got second and about 11. Rockets will come back up to the play. Ball carrier on the play is going to be Muscarelli, and he's met quickly by the Chelmsford defender, but after about a 5-yard gain. So the Rockets march that much closer. They're going to need about 7 yards to get into the end zone. So it's third down. 5 yards to go. 5 yards to go for the first down. About 7 yards to go for the touchdown. And we'll see what they come out here with. They've got the momentum right now, so. And this is 4-down territory. They don't get it here. They're going to go for it on fourth, so. Big play. Let's see what they do. They've got number 8, Muscarelli, quarterback. He's going to drop back and try to pass it. And it's intercepted. Intercepted by the Chelmsford Cougars. So Chelmsford would take over, first and 10 on the 20. Okay, the Chelmsford Cougars will take over on downs. They're at their own 20. Quarterback is in the shotgun. The ball is given to the running back, and he's got some room on the outside. He's in pursuit by number 6 Iapica and number 33. Connor Lerner, who's trying to make it all the way across from the other side, and unfortunately the Chelmsford running back was just that much faster. He was able to scamper 80 yards for a touchdown. So the Chelmsford Cougars, with about 2 minutes left in the half, go up 20-0. Okay, our second player profile of the game, and unfortunately we're not able to really zoom in on the players today because of technical difficulties here with the camera, but we just want to look at number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis. Aiden goes to the Killam Elementary School, and his favorite food is buffalo wings with extra blue cheese. He likes the extra blue cheese, good for him. His favorite superhero is Green Lantern. And when he's not playing football, he enjoys fishing. And when Aiden grows up, Aiden wants to become an architect. So good job. Aiden's been playing great this year, and that's number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis. Okay, Chelmsford will line up for the extra attempt. Looks like they're going to try to kick it this time. Okay, let's see if the Rockets can get in there and block this. As the holder is down on the ground waiting for the long snap, he gives the signal. Ball is there. Oh, it's a fire play. And Nowicki, number three, is not fooled. Great job to get in there and bring the ball carrier down. So the extra point is no good for the Rockets. So Chelmsford would remain 20, Rockets 0, with about probably maybe 2 minutes left in the half. All right, the Rockets set to receive again. And it's a good kick in the direction of Mascherelli, who catches it, falls on it. And the Rockets will take over third down. Excuse me, Rockets take over first down on their own 38. Okay, Rockets come to the line of scrimmage. Desperately want to try to punch one in here before the half. The give is to number 8, who is met hard. After about maybe a 1 yard carry. And he pops up. So good, tough run, and good way to come back up after being hit pretty hard there. After about a yard gain, second down. Rockets are at their own 42 yard line. In a tight formation. Looked like there was a little bit of movement there on the line of scrimmage, but the refs didn't call that. A good no call by the refs there. Mascherelli, again, the ball carrier, went off tackle, left side, gets about 2 yards on the play, and it's going to be third down with about 3 yards to go. The Rockets will take a timeout. I recognize, of course, the Reading Rocket D squad cheerleaders. Once again, getting the fans in the stands going. Seeing excitement. These girls do a great job out there. Your Reading Rocket D Squad cheerleaders.
Look at that, girls. You brought the sun out.
Nice. All right. Let's see what the Rockets can do here. Trying to keep the chains moving in their favor. The give is to, I couldn't tell who that was on the carry. Looks like 21 Beckenhuis, and timeout Reading, but he was able to get the first down, so that'll be a move the chains, and the ball, when we come back after the timeout, will be right at midfield. Okay, first down for the Rockets. The give is to Centrella, who looks like he's trying to pass it, and he's got Beckenhuis on the corner. So nice job, nice completion right there of about 4 yards. And looks like the time might be the factor here, as the Rockets are trying to do something here before the half, before the time runs out. Looks like Centrella is in the shotgun. He's gonna try to pass it again. He's scrambling around back there, looking for somebody to throw it to. Ball is in the air. And oh, the intended target on the play was Beckenhuis, but the ball was broken up and falls incomplete. So I believe that is the half. That is it. So we've got halftime here from Chelmsford with a score 20 Chelmsford, Rockets 0. We'll be back. Okay, as we start second half action here, the Rockets will be receiving back deep number 7, Brendan Lindmark, number 3, Braden Nowicki. Chumpster gets ready to kick off, and second half is underway. Good kick, deep kick, to in the direction of Lindmark, but number 22, Jordan Whitmer falls on the ball. So the Rockets will take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line. Okay, the Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got number 3, Braden Nowicki, split wide left. They are in an I formation with, I believe, Centrella at quarterback. He hands off to number 8, yep, Mascherelli. Gets about a yard on the gain. Second down. Rockets come back up to the line of scrimmage. Looks like they're in the moose formation. And the give is to number 3, Nowicki, who's got some room. Great play right there. Nice little trap play call as Nowicki gets about 20 yards on the play. So a really good hole opened up there by the offensive line. And they're going to move the chain. So they're inside of Cougar territory. First down, Rockets. There was a penalty on the play against Chelmsford. It was a 10-yard penalty. So I'm not really sure what it was. Maybe a face mask, but that's usually 15. Rockets, again, moving the ball. The Centrella gives to Mascherelli, who follows his blockers nicely there on the right side of the line. Number 50, Anderson. Number 71, Donahue. Number 51, Bonacci was over there to allow Mascherelli for a couple yards. So they get second down, 8 yards to go. They're at the Cougar 30-yard line. Looks like Mascherelli is under center. He's going to try to keep it himself. Does a nice job of avoiding one tackler and gets about 7 yards on the play. He's just a little short of the first down as we have an injury timeout on the field. Okay, Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Third down, about 2.5 yards to go for the first down. Got number 10, Santrella, who's gonna give it to number 21, Beckenhuis, on a quick little trap play. Nice call as the Rockets move the chains. First down. Rockets are inside the red zone at the Cougar 18-yard line. And Centrella's got it. It's a pitch pass given to Mascherelli, who's nowhere to go on that play, unfortunately. Stopped, no gain. Rockets going with a split left formation here with Nowicki and Beckenhuis. Wide left, the give is directly to Mascherelli, who's trying to find those blockers on the outside. And he was brought down after about a yard on the play. So we're gonna have third down. About 8 to go here for the first down, as we most certainly are in all 4-down territory. So even if the Rockets don't get the first down here, you can be sure they're going to go for it. As they come up to the line of scrimmage, Centrella under center, power eye formation. As the ball is on the ground, and Centrella wisely just jumps on it before Chelmsford could. Lost down, so it's gonna be fourth down. Okay, the Rockets come up the line of scrimmage again. Big fourth down here, 4th and 8. The give is to Mascherelli, who's trying to truck ahead, but he's gonna end up short. of the first down. So Chelmsford will take over on downs at about their own 20-yard line. Okay, the Rockets come out on defense. Standard 5-3 defense. Chelmsford is going to get the direct snap. The quarterback is chugging along. Going to get about 3 or 4 yards on the play, making it second down. All right, Rockets trying to stop Chelms from advancing here. Quarterback is in the shotgun. The give is to the tailback, who's tripped up immediately. Great play by, looked like, number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, who was able to get in there and stop him. So loss of a yard on the play. I think what we'll... Third down. 7 yards to go for Chelmsford. Ball is snapped. The give is to... Actually, it looks like a quarterback keeper. As the quarterback runs ahead, he's going to move the chains for a first down. And at this point, we'd like to do our last player profile of the game. We'll look at number 20, Noah Roach. Noah is a fifth grader at the Joshua Eaton School. His favorite food is chicken wings. And his favorite superhero is Superman. And when he's not playing football, he enjoys riding a bike. And when he grows up, he wants to be a police officer. That's number 20, Noah Roach. So the Rockets trying to stop him here as the Chelmsford Cougars comes up first and 10. The quarterback, nope, the give is to the running back again, who's going to truck ahead for about 5 yards on the play. I couldn't see who made that play. Might have been number 54, Dylan Burpee. 5 yards for the first down. Jumps comes up to the ball. They've got the two wide receiver right. Quarterback is going to give the ball again to the running back, who's got some room along the outside. He breaks one tackle, does a little duck move to break another tackle. And finally brought down after about a 20-yard run, 25-yard run. But looks like, yeah, we do. We have a flag on the play. I'm not sure who this is against. They're walking back, so it looks like it's against Chelmsford. So the run will be negated. And looks like it could have been a hold on the play. So if that's the case, we're going to back it up 10 yards. And it'll remain second down. All right, so as we start the fourth quarter here, Chelmsford, it looked like they're saying first down. I thought it was second. Anyways, quarterback keeper, and he's piled by number 71, Colin Donahue, and number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, as they stopped the running for a loss there, a good loss of about 5 yards on the play. So it's going to be second and 15. After the loss, Chelmsford comes back up to the line of scrimmage. They've got a two-receiver set left. Quarterback is in the I formation. He's got the running back to his right. It's going to be a quick pass, and it's complete. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica, is in pursuit, along with number 3, Braden Nowicki. And just not enough, as the Chelmsford Cougars are able to rush into the end zone after about a 70, it was about a 65-yard pass completion, making the score 26-0. Okay, Chelmsford's going to line up to try to get the extra kick again this time. The Dan gives the snap. Ball is down. The kick is up. And it's no good. Nice try by Chelmsford, but kick falls. Looks like it was a little short. So Rockets will go back to return the kick. About 8 minutes left in the game. Yes. Okay, the Rockets are back deep to kick, to return the kick. Excuse me, the ball is kicked to number seven, Brendan Lindmark. And he falls on the ball right there. So the Rockets will take over. First down from their own 30-yard line. Okay, the Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage on offense. First and 10. They've got number, couldn't tell who was the ball carrier on that one. Let's see who comes up off the ground. Looks like number 3, Nowicki, was the ball carrier on the play, so. Down and about 5 yards to go, 4 yards to go for the first. Got Nowicki, wide receiver right. Doing a I formation. Centrella is under center. He's going to give the ball to, it was number 8, Rocco Masciarelli, who's hit. After the ball was given to him, he's hit with about a yard pickup on the play, so it's going to be third down. Okay. There was a holding penalty. Oh, it looks like maybe a face mask penalty on the play against Chelmsford, so it's enough to give Reading another 15 yards. Moves the ball across midfield into Chelmsford territory. First and 10, Centrella pitches it back out to Masciarelli, who's trying to get something out of the play. He gets a few, nice run. Gets about 2 yards on the play. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. So they've still got, looks like Masciarelli under center. And he's gonna try to keep it himself, but he is immediately met behind the line of scrimmage for about a yard loss on the play. Bringing up third down. All right, they've got Rockets come out wide receiver right. Two wide receivers right. Looks like they're gonna try to throw the ball, but nope. And number 8, Rocco Masciarelli, carries it himself for about a yard gain. So it's gonna be fourth down and about 4 yards to go. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. They need to get to the Chelmsford 36-yard line in order to move the chains. It's fourth down. And Beckenhuis is going to try to do it. And unfortunately, he's wrapped up behind the line of scrimmage. So the Chelmsford Cougars will take over on downs at about their own 45-yard line. Chelmsford takes... No, we got a timeout ready. All right, Chelmsford takes over, like I said, first down. They're at their own 45-yard line. Quarterback is in the shotgun. The give is to the running back, who's trying to get outside, but great play by number 3, Braden Nowicki, for a really nice tackle right there. And looks like we have a little bit of confusion on the field as the refs are trying to indicate something to the timekeepers. I believe it was to keep the clock going. And yeah, we're gonna have second down and 11 to go. Chelmsford comes up to the line of scrimmage. Wide receiver left, slot left. Quarterback's in center. It's a pitch pass to the running back, as he's trying to make some room, and he's finally tackled by a host of Rocket defenders. It looks like we might have a timeout against Reading. Chelmsford comes back up to the line of scrimmage. They've got third down, 10 yards to go. They're at their own 45-yard line. Quarterback is in the shotgun, and he's going to try to keep it himself in pursuit of Beckenhues. But he gets some great blocking, and he's gone. It's going to be a touchdown against Chelmsford. I don't see any flags on the play. Quarterback rushes into the end zone. We've got a making the score 32-0, Chelmsford. The Chelmsford's going to try the extra point attempt again, and the kick this time is no good. The Rockets with about, actually that might be the end of the game here, folks. As the clock is running down. And it looks like that's it, folks. That's the end of the ball game here. So your final score from Chelmsford, Reading, Chelmsford 32, Reading 0. Good hard-fought battle by the Rockets. Chelmsford was a very, very good team. And boys have nothing. They played hard. They blocked well. They made some tackles. But unfortunately came up short again today. So the Reading D team, we will catch you next week.